five, six, seven, eight.
Be gone, don't make them too strong. Me, get back, come up out of attack. Move, be gone, don't make them too strong. Move, you can't be classy, and don't make them ashy. Move.
Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Sorry, let me start over. So, hey guys, welcome back to my channel, LoveF82. I hope you get LoveF82. Sorry, I hope you guys are doing well. I am. So, before we get started, make sure you like, subscribe, and also click the bell so every single time I post a new video, you guys will get a notification. So, like I say, 2 weeks ago, last week, I forgot to do it last week, or whatever. Or I wasn't really at my work last week, because I think, yeah. So, because I only work like a couple days a week. So basically, I'm going to be trying to do a story time, even if it's like chapter books, about trying to do every week, every other week, so you guys will get something new. So we're gonna be reading 3 board books. So yes, if you're older, you guys will have to wait. Actually, no, because we'll read 3 board books and we'll read 1 book from there. So let me get up. Basically, guys, sorry if you guys, yes, I work at a library. I'm a library assistant, so the British will read this one last, because it's probably longer. So, basically, I'm going to be reading each of these books to you guys, and then I'll write it down in the video, and I'll write it down in the description so you guys can go get that at your guys' library, or you could probably find it online, or you can watch mine again with me reading these books to you. So yes, some of these, okay, there's one book that's about Easter. I know it's not Easter right now, but I just picked one of these books. I was like, you know what? Because usually I try to do it Thursday. This will be my second time. I try to do it Thursday. But then I know it kind of takes me a while to remember to edit it. So I was like, you know what? I'll just wait. So I'm doing it a little bit early. It's fine. I might end up starting to do it 2 times a week. Depending on what I want to post and stuff. So basically, make sure you don't forget to like, subscribe, and also click the bell so every single time I post a new video, you guys will get a notification. Okay, so, okay, so the first book we are going to be reading is In My Flower. It's by Sarah Glenningham and Lorena, that name. Like I said, you guys could probably find this book at your library. As you can see, there's a lot of butterfly on it. So you guys would think. And there's also one where you can stick your finger through. And then you can like shake it around like that. So let's get started. So, in my flower, I drink sweet nectar. I scatter pollen with my wings. I wave to my friends in the sky, so other butterflies or birds, or probably other insects too. Then I rest in the warm sun. So cute. Feels weird because like you're like reading, but you're also like shaking, you know. So sorry if I keep talking. With my family. So that's In My Book by Sarah Dillingham and Lorena. That's, you'll probably find another author named Lorena, some whatever how you pronounce that. That is the illustrator, I'm pretty sure. Yeah. So let's get on with our next book. So guys, our next book is Ollie's Easter Eggs. I've read not a lot, maybe like one or two of their books, and it's pretty good. It's kind of actually funny too. This is Ollie's Easter Eggs by Oliver Dunria, whatever. So basically, yeah, it's funny. So, oh, it's also Creative Goosey and Friends. If you guys have seen those board books, this is written by the same author. So yeah, let's get started. This is Goosey and Gritty. They are gathering eggs. This is Bobo and Petey. They are gathering eggs too. Sorry, so you guys can see the pages. This is Ollie. He is hopping. Goosey dyes her egg bright red. Gertie dyes her egg bright blue. And yes, I'm trying to read it backwards or like, sorry, if you think I'm sticking my hand in my nose, I'm not. I don't know if you're seeing, like, you guys can see it, and it's weird. So, yeah. So that's Goosey and Gertie. Or might be Gritty, but I pronounce it weird. Bobo dyes her egg bright purple. Petey dyes her egg bright yellow. Ollie stares at the brightly colored eggs. I want eggs, he shouted. Goosey hides her egg in the green grass. My egg, whispers Ollie. He rolls the red egg out of the sight. Sight, that is not a word. So then Gritty hides her egg in the yellow straw pile. My egg, whispered Ollie. He rolls the blue egg out of sight. Bobo hides her egg in the red tulips. My egg, whispers Ollie. He rolls the purple egg out of sight. Petey hides his egg under the green turtle. My egg, whispers Ollie. He rolls the yellow egg out of sight. Ollie hides all the eggs under his blanket. Goosey and Gertie hunt for the Easter eggs. They look in the tulips. They look under the turtle. Bobo and Petey hunt for the Easter eggs. They look in the grass. They look in the straw. Goosey and Gertie scoot past Ollie, searching, hunting. Bobo and Petey scurry past Ollie, hunting, searching. Look, Ollie says. Four small gooselings stop and stare. Easter eggs, shouts Ollie. Then, so technically, Ollie took them away, but he wanted to be part of their little friend group, whatever. So he took all the eggs and then he felt really bad and he gave them back. So, yeah. So the next book we are going to be reading is Snuggle Puppy. I love her books. They're so funny and so cute. This is by Sandra Boyton. If you read the back, it goes, ooh, Snuggle Puppy. of mine, Everything About You, is especially fine. So it's like a ooh, snuggle puppy song. And it's so dang cute. And I love it. So, yeah. And these are her other books. We have a whole row that I will show you towards the end of the video of her books. And I'll show you some of the, all these books too. I'll just like show you the names of them. So yeah, we're reading Snuggle Puppy. It's a little love song, apparently. Ooh, la, la. Well, I have a thing to tell you, and it won't take long. The way I feel about you is a kind of song. It starts with an ooh and ends with a kiss. And all along the middle, it goes something like this. It goes, ooh, snuggle puppy of mine. Everything about you is especially fine. I love what you are. I love what you do. Fuzzy little snuggle puppy, I love you. Isn't that so adorable? So cute, guys. So cute. So, so, so cute. Probably for my other books, I'm gonna try to read it another way. See if that's better for you guys. Okay, sorry. I say, ooh, snuggle puppy of mine. Everything about you is especially fine. I love what you are. I love what you do. Sorry, guys, for the title shaking. Ooh, snuggle puppy. I love you. Kiss. Now I wanted just to tell you, and it didn't take long. The way I feel about you is the kind of song. I started with ooh. I gave you a kiss. I hope you like the middle. Now we'll end like this. Whisper it. Snuggle puppy of mine. Everything about you is especially fine. I love who you are. I love what you do. Not loud. Ooh, I love you. Mwah. That is the third. I dropped it. The third of the books. Now I will show you guys with the other books of these, and that will be the last book, so you guys will get a little hint. So actually, I changed my mind. I'll show you guys towards the end, so I can say my goodbyes, and I will thank you guys for watching. So let's read Can I Be Your Dog? The reason why I chose this one, I wanted to choose like Butterfly Park, because I was like, oh my gosh, it's related to one of the board books. Or because I was kind of like in a rush because I was still recording and I didn't stop recording because I would have been sucked or whatever. So I wanted to make this book because I realized that most people who have pets have dogs or cats, but this is a dog book. So it's like, I was gonna pick the butterfly book, like I said, but then I was like, and I saw this cute little doggy. Oh my gosh, it's so cute. And I was like, oh my gosh, most people have dogs, and that would be so cute for me to read to them. And hopefully you guys subscribe more. Right now I only have 13 subscribers. The last time I checked, which was either yesterday or 2 days, or the day before that. But make sure you guys please, I'm gonna cry, please subscribe and tell your friends and family how great I am. Also, leave comments down below on questions so I can do a Q&A, and I will post that for you guys. So yeah, I'm going to be checking my YouTube channel every week to see if you guys have questions, and if you guys do, usually it's to be 5 or more questions before I do a Q&A, but yeah, so that you guys can know more about me, and know more about the library, maybe, or more about the books I read, or maybe about what I do, what I like, and stuff like that. So, yeah, but let's get started with our, Can I Be Your Dog? This is by Troy Cummings. This is the easy author. I'm also gonna put, like I said, I'm gonna put each of the books down in the description, and also I'm gonna like list it probably each time each book I read. I'm gonna like edit it into the video, like the name and the author and stuff, so that you guys could know who read it, you know. Okay, so let's read the book. I'm just reading myself very easily. I don't like it. Okay, so I should have done this an easier way, because a picture book. It is very hard to fold. You know what? You know what I'm about to do? Turn the camera around and show you guys what it looks like. So guys, sorry about that. It was hard. It's easy to read board books like that, but like it's hard because it's like super big, so I'm just going to be I'm gonna be reading this to you guys, so this is what it looks like. Yes, I'm doing it on phone, and I would use a tripod, but I don't feel like it. It's my Troy Cummings. I'm the girl cute doggies. Okay, so this is Dear People at Yellow House. Woof. Can I be your dog? I am potty trained to have my own squeaky bone. Also, I love to play. I see you have a cat, but I'm willing to work with you. Who's a good dog? I am. Sincerely, Arfie. P.S. I know every house on Butternut Street, but I asked you first. So, that's what it looks like. Isn't it so cute? Okay, Dear Arfie, we're so sorry, but you cannot be our dog. Our cat is allergic to dogs. Good luck in your search. The Honeywells. Oh, look at the doggy. He's sad because the Honeywells wouldn't let him live with them. I hope the dog returns at home, right? So, this is what it looks like. Okay. So, it says, Dear Butcher Lady, can I be your dog? I know your butcher shop would be a great place for a puppy like me. I could keep the floor nice and clean. Paw print, Arfie. It's out there. So, this is what it looks like. She goes, look, pal, I've got a bone to pick with you. Last time I let a dog into my shop, a dozen meatballs went missing. Sorry, but there's no way I'm taking it in a pouch. Veronica Shank Butcher. P.S. No hard feelings. Enjoy these dried giblets and good luck finding a home. He's like, these are so good, but he's so sad too. So next he's going to go to the fire station. Dear fire station number 5, can I be your dog? I can fetch your boots. Plus, let's just say I know my way around a fire hydrant. I've sniffed out every single one on the Butternut Street, and yours is the shiniest, Arfie. Okay, now Butternut Street says, Dear applicant, thank you for your interest in working with the Butternut Street Fire Station. Unfortunately, the position of fire dog has already been filled. We will keep your letter on file. Best wishes in your search. Station number 5. So he basically peed on that because he was so mad. So now he's gonna go, Dear Junkyard Guy, I'm not gonna lie, you're my next to last choice, but these past few days, have been rough. Rough. So please, can I be your dog? I don't eat much. I can bark if people try to steal your junk and stuff. Hopefully yours, Arfie. And he wrote, "Dear Mutt, get lost. Dear Last House on Butternut Street, can I be your dog? I see that your yard is full of weeds and your windows are broken and there's this funny smell, but I'm not picky, just lonely, Arfie." That's like a haunted house. Arfie, soggy box in the alley. Return to sender, nobody at this address. Last house on Butternut Street. Arr, he's so sad. It's a piano here. It says, "Dear Arfie, can I be your person? I need a friend who will be with me no matter what. Snow, rain, heat, or gloom of night. And I see what you already know. That you already know everyone on Butternut Street. Oh, I know you'll make a first-class partner. With hugs and head scratches, Misty Whipple, letter carrier. P.S. If you agree, meet me at the Big Blue Mailbox." So. Look, will he come? Oh, he came. "Dear Mincy, you know what? My tail has been wacky ever since I got your note. My answer is yes. Truly yours, Arfie. P.S. Woof. Scratch, scratch." So basically, let's read this. "Here's how you can help a homeless animal. Adopt a shelter animal instead of buying a pet. Volunteer at a shelter or pet adoption event. Spay or neuter your pet so there will be fewer for babies to find a home for. Donate to your local animal shelter or a national animal advocacy group such as American Society for the Prevention of Cruelty to Animals or ASPCA.org or the Human Society or humansociety.org. Extend a helpful paw so all your animal friends can find forever homes, Arfie." So I'm gonna show you guys some of the Sandra Boynton books. So we got Tickle Time, we have Silly Lulup, Silly Lullaby, we have Doggies. There. We have What's Wrong, Little Pookie. We have Barnyard Dance. We have Moo Ba La La La. We have Spooky Pookie. Night Night, Little Pookie. Blue Hat, Green Hat. Happy Hippo, Angry Duck. But not the hippopotamus. That's her books. The duck books for the, We have Boo Boo, we have Gus, we have Jasper, and Joop. So guys, that's basically all. I just wanted to say thank you guys for watching. And make sure you like, subscribe, and also comment down below on questions you wanna ask me so I can give you guys a Q&A. Make sure, I'm not gonna do a Q&A unless there's 5 questions or more. Unless it's just a single question, I could probably give you guys at least a 5-minute video about it. So thank you guys for watching. Love you all.